everyone, I'm Kaho. Welcome to my talk, Beats in the Browser. I'll be showcasing various ways of making music with React and Next.js. A little bit about me first. I'm a software engineer at AgriWebb. We're a livestock management platform. We're based in Sydney, Australia. I'm also part of a hip-hop band called The Herd, Australian hip-hop band, and I release music under the name Uncle Ho. There we are. See if you can find me. I'm kind of tucked away in the back there. As a musician and developer, I thought, why not combine beats into the browser? I've got a few music demos with Next.js and React, but more importantly, I wanted to showcase how the browser can be a legitimate music platform. This is all made possible with a library that I've been building called Reactronica. It's an audio library for React. It's a wrapper around Tone.js, inspired by React Music by Ken Wheeler. Normally, React treats UI as a function of state, but Reactronica treats music as a function of state. I've got a live code demo where I'll use Reactronica's song, track, instrument, and effect components. And I'll live code and play music using fast refresh. Just let me get set up. All right, so on our left here is all the code. On the right is the browser. That's where the audio is coming from. If you've got headphones, feel free to put them on. I've got the console showing so you can see fast refresh in action. Here we've got Reactronica, all the components, song, track, instrument, and effect, a little bit of state. Here's the play button, and there's the song component in action with is playing, BPM, and volume props. Inside that is a track component with some steps, and these steps are the notes that get played. Currently it's set to a one bar loop. Inside the track is an instrument component, and this type of instrument is a sampler. And right now I have a drum kit. All these samples are mapped to MIDI notes. And so right now this is just a kick, so we'll just have a quick listen. So let's update this and add the snare. Add a kick. One more snare. I do want to add the hat at the same time as the kick, so I'll nest this array. So let's just keep on adding them. Let's make it a bit more interesting and syncopate it. There we go. I also like it a bit slower, so let's bring it down to 100, 90, how about 85? Now so we can see what's going on, I'll add this index state in. So this is coming from on step play. Getting triggered every step. We also have an 808, so let's get some bass in there. So that is F3. There we go. It's a bit short, so I'll make that into an object. Adjust the duration, so that will play for half a bar. I'll have it on the offbeat though. That's better. You can also add effects as well. There's a little reverb. You can layer tracks together as well. So this track is a synthesizer, browser synth. So let's unmute that. You can add effects to this as well. You can change the sound too. We also have a vocal sample down here, so I'll unmute that. Change it up a bit. You can adjust the delay time as well. And lastly, we have a viola sample. It's got some effects as well. Hope you enjoyed that. Let's get back to the rest of the talk. So we've got another demo. This one is inspired by Ableton Live. If you're not familiar with Ableton Live, it's a digital audio workstation. It's a lot of people, a lot of music producers, DJs use it to perform for live gigs and also to produce music. Looks a bit like this. This is the session view where you can play live. My demo won't look anything like that, but I'll try and get close. It's built with, of course, Next.js, Tailwind, Recoil, and Frame of Motion. Plus a dash of GraphQL, Apollo, and Hasura. Let's check it out. So here's the interface. The top section is divided up into channels of beats, bass, samples, vocals, piano, and Santor. And down the bottom is all the notes that get played by each of these clips, and I can select them, activate them, switch between them as well. I can also clear them up as well. But yeah, let's get to it. Closer. I might leave it there. So I've got another song that I've been writing. This one's called Miss You. And, whoa, hey, Luke, how's it going?
Good, man. How are you?
I'm just in the middle of recording a talk.
Yeah.
Actually, do you want to join in? Because, like, this software is all, you know, connected by GraphQL, real-time subscriptions, WebSockets. You might even have the link already.
I have it open in my browser.
Wow, by coincidence. Thank you. Well, this is Luke. He's a developer, musician, frequent collaborator, very old friend of mine. Let's do it. Okay.
All right.
3, 4.
It's you.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah, no worries. That was fun.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's good to collaborate again. And yeah, I better get back to this talk. So hope you have a nice rest of the day.
Thanks, man. You too. Enjoy the rest of the talk.
Yeah. Cheers. Bye.
Bye.
Well, that was a nice surprise. Well, here's me in the background there. I'm playing with that software, early version of it, at a gig that actually Luke put on. All right, last demo. Here I'll be trying to replicate the MPC style drum pads. If you're not familiar with the MPC, it's a Akai drum machine, and you might have seen this before, but it's the classic 4x4 16 kind of pads, and people drum on it. People compose on it, you can write beats with it, you can write full songs with it. It's a classic. Really fun. Now, Reactronica allows you to sequence music, but you can also trigger sounds with it, and that's using the notes prop. I'll show you that in a sec. I'm going to do something a little bit crazy and try to connect this to Chrome. Using Web MIDI.js. This is a USB drum machine. Not as good as the Akai, but does the job. the way that Reactronica sets these notes down here is that you just set some state, and then you have a button. You set the notes to whatever note you want. In this case, it's a symbol. And then when you mouse up, when your mouse is off, you remove those notes. And that kind of gives you the ability to play live with Reactronica. I'm going to connect it up with MIDI using WebMini.js. I'm just going to get set up. Give me a second. So I've set up some MPC drums here, just in the browser. I can trigger these using the notes prop for a snare, but I can also trigger using this trigger finger, USB MIDI device, and it's connected to Chrome via WebMini.js. Okay, I'm gonna try and bash out a beat. That's all that I've got for today. Massive thanks to Vercel for putting this on. I hope you got a bit inspired today to use the web in creative ways. Doesn't have to be music either. It is an incredible platform. If you're interested in the talk, I've got a repo here for you, and also one for Reactronica. And all the samples that you heard before all came from Splice. It's kind of a sample as a service. Enjoy the rest of the conference. See you.